Let's give everyone a second to just say yes to that. Okay, we're good. Yeah, everyone's giving the thumbs up. Okay, Pooja, go ahead.
Thank you, Rafit. Thank you so much, everybody, for joining on a Sunday evening. And we're really excited to have Rafit here with us again. The last event with Rafit was basically how to make a CV. And Rafit just blew our minds with his creative ideas and his brand new insights. So today we thought we'd do a live CV review where some of you were kind enough to send in your resumes to us, and Rafit will be reviewing them live for you all. And I think we have 7 minutes are passed after time, so I think we should begin now. What do you think, Rafit?
Yes, let's begin. I think that's a good idea. So welcome, everyone.
I'm sorry, just one more thing. If any one of you wants, has not filled the form yet, but still they want to get their resume reviewed, you can DM me on Discord. You can send in your resume. I will hide the private details and I'll get it reviewed. So that's there.
Awesome. All right. So there was one more person joining here, Zell Froster. Welcome. So good to have everyone. Good to see so many people. I'm really excited about this event. So I think we should start. But again, I like to make sure that everyone is comfortable first. So let's do a little kind of fun thing before we get into the meat of the event. So last time, those of you who were here, I was sharing with you some songs from Bollywood, and we were supposed to figure out which movie it was from. Let's do a slightly different thing this time. This time I'm going to share my screen and show you a little scene from a movie. And you are again supposed to figure out which movie it is from. So just a fun thing to get us started. So I'm going to share my screen, and I'm going to, hopefully the audio is going to work as well. And then as soon as you have the name, just go ahead and write it in the chat. Okay, let me set this up here. And there's more people joining as well. Okay. Let's see here. Share my screen. And there we go. Can everyone see the screen? Please go ahead and say yes if you can see the screen in the chat. Yes, yes, yes. Okay, perfect. Awesome. Looks like it's working. So let's go ahead and roll the first scene. It's going to be about 1 minute of content. And so make sure to listen to it properly and see it, and then guess which movie is it from. Let's see. Make sure your sound is on as well, and let's start. I wanted to make sure that I just ran the whole thing so everyone could have a guess, but we got someone pretty fast. Let's see who was first. Satyam was first with Super 30. Yes, indeed, it is from Super 30. It's from the intro part of it. Really cool scene. So good job, everyone who figured it out. If someone has already said the right answer in the chat, still feel free to say it anyway, right? Okay, so yeah, if you haven't watched this movie, Gina, you said I had no clue. It's a really good one, Super 30. It's based on that life of the Anand Kumar, I think he's called, who started the Super 30 movement basically at this point. And I saw it a couple of years ago, and it's a really good one. I highly recommend it. One more person joining us. This is good as well to start with this, so people can still join a little bit late, right? So let's let a new person join with audio before we proceed to the next scene. Oh, there we go. We got another person as well. Seems like Praksha hasn't joined audio. Let me just put it in the chat. Hi, Praksha. Join audio. Okay, let's continue, and then if we're having any problems, then we can take it as we go. Okay, so the second scene, I'm going to share my screen again. Let's see. This one, ready? There we go.
I'd like to wish you the best of luck. Any questions?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Wo bahar casualty mein koi marne ki halat mein raha. तो उसको फॉर्म भरना जरूरी है क्या?
तुम्हारी क्लासेस कल सुबह 8 बजे शुरू होगी. थैंक यू वेरी मच.
या सो दिस वन एज वेल यू गाइस गॉट सो फास्ट. लेट्स सी हु गॉट इट फर्स्ट. Someone said, Pooja said two idiots, not three idiots. That's close though, but I think you probably misspoke. Munabhai MBBS is the one that it's from. APK got it first, so congratulations to you. Good one. I think everyone else was also saying Munabhai after that. Classic movie, a really good movie. It's one of my favorite movies, I think. It just has such a great message, and it's like a really feel-good movie, you know, one of those. So, yeah. Let's do the last one. Let's see here. There we go. So let me share my screen once again. I hope everyone has joined audio. The people who just joined, Praksha, welcome. There was one other person who also just joined. I didn't catch who you were, but welcome as well. I hope you all can hear and also see me. If there are any technical problems, please let us know in the chat. Okay, last one.
आप करते क्या
हैं? जी कुछ नहीं.
अच्छा. अब मेरा मतलब है जी कुछ करने की जरूरत नहीं पड़ती. बाप ने बहुत कमाया है. बाप का बहुत बड़ा बिजनेस है. बहुत बड़ा कारोबार है.
कौन सा बिजनेस?
गारमेंट्स. गारमेंट्स का बिजनेस है. हम लोग गारमेंट्स एक्सपोर्ट करते हैं. यहाँ कुछ नहीं आता है. सब बाहर जाता है. सब बाहर जाता है. नाम सुना होगा आपने? चौधरी एंड सन्स. चौधरी एंड सन्स. हाँ हाँ, चौधरी एंड सन्स. सुना है? नाम सुना है?
सुना है?
हाँ, क्योंकि आपके यहाँ जो कपड़ा आता है वो हमारी कंपनी से आता है. मैदान ग्रुप टेक्सटाइल कंपनी. बहुत बड़ी कंपनी है. बहुत लोगों को उधार देते हैं. सबको सबको उधार देते.
Well done on this one too. You guessed it as well. Let's see who got that one first. Let's see, this one was also APK. You're pretty fast. Andaz apna apna, of course it's that one. So good job everyone. This one is a classic comedy movie, probably one of the funniest movies that I've ever seen in my life. Does anyone agree with me? I think it's just so stupid, but it's just so funny. And I watched it probably, I don't know, at least 30 or 40 times, and maybe even more. And it's with, of course, Aamir Khan and Salman Khan, when they were pretty young, in the mid 90s. But yeah, it's a fun one if you want to check it out. It was a big part of my childhood. Okay, so that was this one, and we have some more people joining. To keep up with me, you got to watch more Bollywood. Yeah, maybe I'm not so familiar with the later Bollywood stuff, the latest ones. I'm more of a 90s, 2000s person. Okay, so first thing that I want to say to you all is that you probably can hear it in my voice. I'm a little bit ill. I have a sore throat. Yeah, could everyone mute? I heard some echo there. So I have a little bit of a sore throat. I'm not feeling that great. So, you know, excuse my voice. It's one of those things, you know, when you have something important like an exam or an event and you just fall ill the day before. That happened to me once again. Happened so many times in my life. Has that ever happened with you guys? like you have a really important exam the day after, and then you fall ill, you have a fever. Happened to you too? Yeah. I have a little story for you guys. Way back in 2010, I think it was, when I was much younger than I am now, I was 19 years old in 2010. And I was going to give an exam because I did, do you guys know about this thing called IB? Do you have it in India? International Baccalaureate. It's like this high school program. No? Well, it's pretty popular in Europe and America. It's basically you can take your whole education in English. And at the end of the 2 years, you have to give exams. And basically everyone in the world gives the same exams. And so it's this kind of rigorous high school alternative to whatever you have locally offered. So for me, I was either going to do that or I was going to do the Norwegian curriculum. And I wasn't really into that because I thought, you know, I was really interested in sciences and I had to take a bunch of other subjects there, plus do it in Norwegian, which I didn't really want to do because I wanted to go outside of Norway after I was done with my high school. So I decided to do this. It's all in English. But you have JEE, mains, and advanced, of course, right, for the IIT university system. I am familiar with that. Yeah, so anyway, we had this, and I was applying to universities, and one of the universities that I applied to was Oxford University, and they had an entrance exam, and I was studied, and I applied for math, studying math, bachelor's in math, and I had done this entrance exam that they had, which I did pretty good on. You know, the cutoff, I scored a bit above the cutoff consistently over time when I was preparing, and I was feeling pretty good. And so I was supposed to go to this place to give this exam. I was the only person giving the exam. And the day before, I got a fever and I couldn't sleep for even a minute during the entire night. And I was just, you know, feeling horrible the day after, obviously completely bombed the exam. And also as a result, didn't even get called in for an interview, much less get accepted to the university. So that's probably my biggest memory of being really ill before something really important. I don't know if you have something similar to that, right? It really, really sucks when that happens. Anyway, with that out of the way, let's start this event. And yeah, it was pretty sad, Anurag. It was really, really sad. I was pretty bummed out for a while after that. So for this event, what we wanted to do, because the last event was pretty good, we wanted to make it so that I can give you some more kind of concrete advice about what to think about and how to think about things. So we have a couple of people who sent in their resumes before the event. So I'm going to start with those. And the way we're going to do it is that I'm going to share my screen. I'm going to show you the resume. And if it's one of yours and you happen to have something there that you for some reason don't want to share or don't want to be out as a recording, let us know afterwards. And before we put out this recording, we can take those things away, right? So let's start with that right away. I'm going to open up the first one. Let's see here. There we go. So the personal information here is wiped out. And here's how I want to do it. So I want this to be as interactive as possible. So any question you have or comment you have, please go ahead and write it in the chat. And I'm going to have an eye on that as we go. So before I share my screen, I want to just say that I'm going to try to pretend to be a person on the other side, right? So we're trying to think about this from the point of view of the person looking at your resume and having the power to do something about it, right? Get you to the second round or whatever it is. So with that said, let's open this up. There we go. Okay, so I think this is a good first one to start off with. I think most resumes look like a variation of this in some way. Now, before we go into things that we can do better, let's look at all the things that are really good here, okay? So, of course, the name is blocked out. That would be here, and then the email and everything. So let's kind of go past that. We have education qualifications, and so I know exactly which bachelor's degree this person is doing, where they're doing it from, at the institute, And then all the information about education is written here. I don't think I would have any more questions past this. So this is good. This is a very complete part of the resume, right? You have all the information that you'd want to give the person. So that's good. Then we have internship. So let's see here. Well, we have data analyst intern. Also probably going to ask you guys some questions as we go. If I don't understand this, you guys probably know this much better than me. So we have internship. And then, so this was an internship that they did, I'm assuming, right? Because it says here, February 2022 to April 2022, 2 months. That's good to include the date and how much you work there. Now let's go ahead and read this part. Analyze the data to draw trends from the job application. Mapped, rated, and reviewed the app using mapping tools. Employed expertise in MS Excel, Microsoft Excel, and technical abilities to verify the precision of the data. Updated hiring status and managed data of interns through telephonic inquiry. Okay, at this point, I want to pause a little bit. Okay, I want to ask you guys a question. From this description that this person has given, do you understand what they did at this job? Yes or no? Please go ahead and write that in the chat. Priyankar says no. Okay, not very clearly. Mm-hmm. No. Okay, go ahead. Just whatever you think, yes, no. We're all here to be better, right? Not clearly, but getting the idea, nope. Okay, I would agree with you here. I'm not really sure what this is about. So let's go through it again here. Data analyst intern. Okay, data analyst. That says to me something. They're working with data and they're supposed to take data and make sense of it probably, right? Medha, is that the name of the company? Could you help me out here? That would be the name of the company. Okay. So data analyst intern there. They were only there for 2 months, so not long, right? But analyze the data to draw trends from the job application. See, this doesn't tell me that much. I'm not really sure what this means. So let's go ahead here. Mapped, rated, and reviewed the app using a mapping tool. So they're referring to the app, which I don't know what it is. Is that the app that the company makes? The main product that they have from the job application? I'm not really sure, you know, what that is referring to either. Employed expertise in Excel and technical abilities to verify the precision of the data. Okay, that also, I'm not really sure what that means in this case. Updated hiring status and managed data of interns through telephonic inquiry. So I suppose this involves updated hiring status. So going in and updating the records that they have, and maybe you need to phone the people to kind of make sure of stuff, right? Okay, so again, I like to say, if the person who sent this resume is here, I like to first applaud you for putting yourself out there and letting us do this thing publicly. That's a really good step. But let's stop here for a little bit and see how we can make this better. So do you guys have any ideas for how you can write, not necessarily this, but anything that you did at an internship for some time to give a very good idea of the person who's talking? There's another person who's joining us, by the way. There we go. How can we write this better? Any ideas? What would you include? How would you start this? Let's see if you guys have any ideas. It's not articulated properly. The descriptions would change your resume drastically. Mm-hmm. Maybe include what type of data. That's a good idea. I agree with that. That's a very good idea. Anything else would be worth mentioning? How the app works and how I have done. That's good. Maybe giving it a title. Mm-hmm. Tech stack used. Yeah. Help the company by drawing out trends. Yeah. But guys, I think what I like to do is this. I don't know about you guys, but sometimes I find when reading resumes, and I've done this a lot, I've read a lot of people's resumes. One of the things that I really hate is when they use these kind of fancy words that doesn't really give me much understanding of what that really means, at least in this context. And so what I like to do personally is just make my vocabulary really simple. Like I'm not I'm like a 10-year-old or a 15-year-old reading this thing who doesn't have any knowledge of whatever you did, right? You got to kind of assume that. So first, I would like to understand which company did you work at and what do they really do? What does Medha do? Because I don't understand that from this. I would probably have to copy and paste that into Google and try to do some research and really trying to understand what this company does. And if you're making me do that, you've already kind of lost me a little bit because I want to get that from you right here, right? So I would start with this. Medha is a company that blah, 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 does this and that. One or two sentences, not much. But write it in your own words and make it super clear what it is that you do. Because that has to be established first before I can get an idea of what you, a specific person, did in that company in relation to everyone else, right? So always start with that. What is it that the company produces? Do they produce an app? Is it a SaaS product, software as a service? Is it a consulting company? Is it a petroleum company? What is it, right? And then, again, with very few words, say what it is that you specifically worked on. Now, before you can do that, you kind of have to state a little bit of a problem. Because the fact that you worked on something was probably because there was a problem that you or your team needed to solve. So also try to, you know, make me understand that, like, what is it that you were really working on? Where was the problem? And then very naturally from that comes, what is it that you specifically worked on? How did you add value to this company? And you might think, well, I didn't really do that in the 2 months that I was there. And maybe you're right. That is, unfortunately, what happens a lot, especially with interns. They don't really get much important stuff to do. It's just a fact of life, right? But you can still turn it into something that, well, I might not have given that much value to the company. And if that's the case, you don't need to mention anything. But you can just say, what can you say instead of that? Please help me out here in the chat. What can you say instead of giving value to the company? What can you mention instead of that? Any ideas? Remember, this is not so much about the company, but you as a person. No ideas? Well, if you didn't add that much company, if you didn't add that much value to the company, well, what type of value did you add to yourself? Did you learn anything from this place? Did you grow as a person? Did you get better at writing technical things? Did you get better at Microsoft Excel? Whatever it is, figure that out and focus on that. Because that also gives me, as the person reading this, something that, oh, okay, so this person learned this. They learned a little bit of Python as a result of this job. Okay, that's good. That's kind of cool. Finding problems faced which could have a solution by gaining more skills. Yeah. Yeah. So remember, whatever happens in whether you've done internships, education, whatever, try to focus it more on yourself and not the company that much. At the end of the day, you are a person who's going through life and learning new things, right? And especially where you are in life, younger people in their teens and early 20s, you're learning at a very fast pace. So you gotta really make me, as the person reading your CV, understand, okay, this was a little stop in the journey of this person. And so what I just realized that the name here is, I was sharing that too. I'm going to block that out later. Don't worry about that. We're going to blur that out. So yes, I was saying that in your journey as a person, there was a 2 month stop that you did at this internship. If you got something out of that, you really got to, you know, make the person understand that this is what I learned from that. And this is what it has helped me later on. Okay, I think I've gone into it in pretty much detail. I think we all understand. Let's go past this now. Positions of responsibility. All right, let's see. So we have event management head, career counseling and placement cell of something college, led the whole team in implementing a successful in-person internship in a place. Okay, this is good. You led a whole team in implementing a successful in person internship and placement fair. This gives me a lot more information than what came before it. So this is pretty good. Conducted and hosted webinars and seminars featuring eminent speakers and trained the team on organizing public events in both offline and online modes. Again, this is really good. I'm really liking this. And I wish you would put this actually further up in your resume. I want to read this faster. So this is pretty good. Okay, so I understand pretty good. Okay, so you're part of organizing events, both in person and offline, with prominent and eminent speakers. Here, you don't have to do this, of course. Eminent speakers is good enough. But if you had a person that participated or was the speaker that kind of everyone knows, or is a famous person, you can say, you can even mention their names. And then that would go make me go, okay, I can Google them. Oh, they are kind of a big deal in this thing. Okay, that's pretty cool. That's just a little tip here. Increase the number of workshop registrations by 70% through effective planning. This I like as well too. So you improved it by 70%. This actually, I don't know how you would bake it in here, but if you made this into a bigger deal, if you know how you did that, what it exactly was, if you remember that, then I would go more deeper into that, because I would really like to see that 70% increase. That's a pretty big thing. Can you mention two or three of the things or the strategies that you applied to do that? That would just add something more here. Assisted in distributing over 300 internships and job placements opportunities monthly. This is also very good. I really like this section. Good job on this one. Well done. I think this is pretty good. Joint secretary and English debating college. Okay, so this is kind of the same type of thing. So we're not going to go into this. It's very close to what you did before. School captain, principal, teachers, and social. Okay, this is really good. This is really good. Now, what this tells me here is that you're a person who can get people to get together and come to events, right? You can get excited about that. So I would make, I don't know what you're applying for here specifically, or if you're just applying for anything, but if you want to kind of narrow down a little bit more on what it is it exactly that you're applying for, in this case, I would assume that this is some sort of a community manager position that you're looking for, maybe, you know, something to do with people and organizing events. If that's the case, I would make this the centerpiece of your CV. I would focus on this and come up with, and what you've done already is pretty good. You've said that you've brought results, which is good. But if you want to go one step further in that, that would be, can you give me a specific story, right? A specific example of some event that you organized, and that because of you, something good happened, right? There was a successful event with X person and this many people came. So I always like to kind of give specific examples because those stick in people's minds so much more than just saying something like, you know, 70% increase or 300. Numbers don't usually stick in our brains, but stories do. So whenever you can do that, that's usually a good thing. And then you have some projects here. And then, of course, you have certifications and then achievements. Let's see, after school tutoring. So you some stuff you did after school, and then you have your skills at the bottom here. There we go. Okay. So again, I would like to say good job on this one. Let me actually go through the CVs first and maybe a little bit faster. And let's at the end, if we have a little bit of time, try to see how we can kind of re-engineer those and redesign it into something different, using something like Figma, a design tool. So let's close this one. Okay, is everyone still with me? Can you say yes in the chat if you're still with me and you're still listening? Hopefully that wasn't too boring. I don't like to go on and talking too much before I check in with you guys. Was that something valuable that you guys got from that? Do you have any questions or thoughts or anything like that? Let me know. Okay. Very nice. Okay, good to hear that. Let's go to the second one. Let's see. There we go. All right. let's try to hide a person's name this time, unless they have it in the CV and it doesn't matter. Yeah, okay, they have it. Okay, so I'm going to not make the same points over and over again. So let's look for the unique stuff with each one, right? So here we have education here. I think all of you are pretty much putting your education up there. And then skills, this is pretty good. Skills coming right away. JavaScript, Python, okay, good. Very good. I want to stay on this point a little bit because I know that people are a little bit unsure about this. But can you write in the chat, when is it that you write something as a part of your skill set? Is it when you've just done a little bit of it, seen a YouTube tutorial on it, and then you go, yeah, okay? Or are you like, okay, I've built something in it, so if they were to ask me something on the spot, I could probably create something from scratch, more or less. So can you enlighten me a little bit? One project done in that skill. Okay, that's good. The latter should have a foundational knowledge. The other one, yeah. I have a question. Is it okay to add CGPA? CGPA, that's a different thing from the GPA. What is the C in that? Could you say that, Priyanka? Just the GPA, yeah. Let's talk about that a little bit later. Thank you for bringing that up. Let's talk about that towards the end. I'll make a note of that. About that. Anuraga saying it's a required for campus placements. So there you go. That's your answer on that. Good knowledge on that skill. Yeah. So just remember, because the reason I ask that, because when I was in college, people were being very generous towards themselves of writing whatever, you know, as I just wanted to make sure. I think that's very good to have done at least one project in it. So that you can, if they ask you, you can point to something, you know, this is my code on GitHub, or you can even see the code, the project live. So that's pretty good. Just make sure that if they ask you questions about that thing, that you can at least say something. So you don't make a fool of yourself. If they say something and you know, you can't do anything. That's a little bit, because I don't think they do it intentionally, but they might just want to test you sometimes. So that's good to have. That's pretty good. You put the skills up there. Then you have your projects, which is talk technology, the tech stack. And then let's see here, is this a link? Yeah, so this opens it up on GitHub and you can see the code. Perfect. Let's see, a full stack chat application that supports real-time messaging and notifications. Oh, that's pretty good. That's very well explained. Supports one-on-one chats and group chats. Very good. User registration and login along with auth using JWT. Okay. And then basically have the same kind of thing there. I think this is pretty good. With projects, can I hear some thoughts here? What is it that you can do when it comes to projects? Any more ideas to make it even better? Please add deployment link. Yes, please do that. Please do that. If you can, please give me a link so that I can open it up on my end and test it out. That is so satisfying whenever you can do that. That's a great idea. That's a great suggestion, Priyankar. GitHub link too, that's always good to include as well. Let them go to your GitHub and then they can see the code if they want to. It's good to have. Read me in the GitHub. Yep, that's good too. I agree that deployment is, if you're going to prioritize, deployment is probably better than code. Because most people are just not going to go into the code, especially the people that are looking at your resumes as the first person in the chain of command. They might not even be coders a lot of the times, and they won't even understand it. But if you can include a link, then they can try it out. Now, does anyone have an idea for something that is even better than a deployment link? What could be even better than that? Any ideas? A demo video. Yes, Satyam, good job. Yes. Remember, I talked about this a little bit the last time, but let me just say it again because this is important. With your CV, people, you can see that all the CVs that we're going to look at, they basically look the same. It's, you know, kind of, you know, text and it's like divided into sections. Who said that it has to be that way? No one did, really. Oh, there are a bunch of people on Google saying that, of course. But it's just because other people that came before them said the same thing. There's no rule that they have to be like this. Not really. Right? So what I would love here in this case is TalkTalk, a chat application. That's so cool. Give me a screenshot of it. Better yet, give me a screenshot that I can click and that opens up a YouTube video, 1 minute, 2 minute, one max, not too long, where you go through the thing, maybe even show your face if you're comfortable with that, but go through it, show it to me. That's even better than a deployment link. Because you know what's going to happen with a deployment link? You're going to give that and then it's going to have some sort of Google authentication and it's going to not work. That happens half the time. Things fail, right? And when people aren't you who made the thing, they don't know where to click. Believe me, I've tried this a lot with people. I'm like, this, no one can misunderstand this thing that I made. And then they have a million questions about how to use it. And am I making any sense? Has that happened with you guys when you've made stuff and shown it to people? Yeah, because you're building the thing, right? You're thinking about it all the time, but you know, show it to your mom and they're like, what is this? Why do I even need to spend my time away from my TV show to be looking at this, right? Ask most people. That's where you got to put most people. So a couple of words of advice here would be, please give me something visual. These are projects. Projects are visual. Give me images and video. If you can make videos, short videos for all three of these, oh my God, you're like 100, you know, times ahead of anyone else. But good job, though. These are pretty good projects, I'm sure. So I'd love to see them, too. Work history. Yeah, so I like that you put your work history down here because you don't have that much work history, right? So it's good to prioritize in a way where you want to focus more on the stuff that comes first. And if you don't have that much, you put it at the end. So good job on making that decision. And then you have extracurricular activities too. So good job on this one. Again, we're going to come back to this towards the end. Let's try to go through the remaining two here that I have quickly. There we go. Okay. So again, you got your education, your experience. This person has more experience. So that's, of course, a positive if you have that. So let's see here. Coursework, undergraduate, you have your courses listed out. This is pretty cool, where you have specific things listed out. So you've taken data structures and algorithms, and this is a good addition. Skills, similar to how it was in the last one, but you go a little bit more in detail. Good job on that. And then let's have a look at your experience here. So remote. In Spain, and you're apparently doing this still, site reliability engineer, developed and maintained critical infrastructure component, and supporting the rapid scaling, implemented and maintained proactive. Okay, yeah, so this is obviously a person who has a lot of technical knowledge. They already have a lot of experience with different things here. You can see that immediately, right? This is a person who is very technical and at a pretty high level. So what you're doing here is that you have these keywords that you're using, right? So you're using AWS Cloud, Kubernetes, most of these things, I don't even know what it is. But Docker, of course, I know. So this is also good that you put these words in, because a person, not so much a technical person, hopefully a more technical person is looking at this thing, but our eyes just automatically kind of are attracted to those words. So I'm probably going to kind of not even read this through, because it's a lot of text, right? It's a little bit intimidating how much text it is, but I'm going to probably see like, oh, AWS. Okay, well, that's good that this person has experience in that. Kubernetes. Okay, nice. And oh, they've done this continuous deployment thing, you know? Okay, so that's pretty good. I still think, now again, I'm not the best at this, I have to say, because I myself have a technical background, but not as much. And so, but what I think happens here is it's very easy to kind of fall back on this thing where you use a lot of technical words and lingo, right? You're thinking, well, I know a lot of stuff and I need to get everything communicated to the person who's reading this. And again, you want to kind of make it so that this thing is approachable also to the not so very technical person at the company that you're applying to. Let me give you an example. Let's say that you're applying to a startup that consists of five people, okay? And there's a CEO, there's a CTO, and there's an operations person, and there's like coders and designers. If you apply to this company, probably the CEO is going to see your CV first. And so the CEO might not be the technical founder, right? That's probably the CTO if they're co-founders. So I can think that that person will have a little bit of difficulty understanding all the things here. So what you can do in that case is that you can still go a little bit more technical later on in your experience. See, you did it where you have four different points there, right? But you could reserve that technicality to the last point, for example, and then make the first three very understandable to the non-technical person. Because again, at the end of the day, you gotta realize that most of us have very low reading retention. When we read something and you ask about it the day after, we barely know maybe 10% of it if you're lucky, right? And if it's not written in the form of a story and a narrative where you're saying that, where you're telling a specific story where I worked at this company and I solved this specific problem in this way, that's very memorable. But when you're using words like implemented and maintained proactive monitoring solutions that enabled quick identification and resolution of potential issues in cloud and Kubernetes environments, I kind of understand what you do with that, right? If you have some technical understanding, but it's not really going to stick that much. And that's your main objective at this beginning of a stage. You want to make yourself as memorable as possible. And if you really want to go into the technical stuff, you can reserve more of that to the second or third round when the CEO has said, okay, I like this person. And then probably what's going to happen is that they're going to hand this over to the CTO, like, hey, just make sure, vet this guy. So they're going to go through your resume and probably understand more of it and then have a chat with you, right? So do understand that this whole process of getting a job is a multi-layered, multi kind of point journey. You can't overwhelm people with all of the information in like the very technical language all at once, because most people are just going to not get it. So you want to be able to kind of save some stuff for later and think like, okay, who's most likely going to be seeing my CV at this stage. And then I can, we can take the technical stuff. All of this stuff is going to come out. Most of it is going to come out when you have the technical talk with the technical person later on anyway. But of course, I understand the flip side to that too, because you want to show with this that I have this much experience, because you do. I can already see this is a resume of a very impressive person who's done a lot already. So there is a little balance there that hopefully we can look at a little bit later. Okay, so let's see if there's anything here. Looks good for eyes. Sorry, DevOps. True, went a little bit over technical. It can be reduced, but nice resume. I agree. This is a very nice resume. And again, I already see this is a very impressive person. I would definitely reach out to you, because in my case, I would be pretty technical. So I would be like, okay, got to talk to this person. So I would definitely invite you for a meeting or a telephone. So well done. Really well done. Okay, let's do the last one. And we do also have some on Discord, I see from Pooja. I don't think we're going to be able to go through everyone here. We started a little bit late, so I'm going to ask this now. After the hour, can you stay for longer? And if yes, can you stay 15 minutes longer, 30 minutes? Could you please write here? Yes, yes, most people are saying yes. Even if you can't, remember, this is being recorded, right? So you're going to see it on YouTube. You're going to see it on Spotify anyway. So I just want to make sure that I can get everyone in here, because I know it can be a bummer if you kind of wanted your resume, you submitted it and it wasn't given feedback. So, okay, that's good. Then we're going to be going a little bit above time then. All right, so let's see here. This one I'm going to say right away, good job on the design. Dark mode, like that. There's some stuff going on up here, which is pretty good. You've put more work into this to make it look nicer. So well done on that. You got your social links up here, which is a really good addition. Probably want to go into your LinkedIn and see on Twitter what type of a person you are, you know, get a little bit more sense of the type of person you are. Summary, I'm so glad that you added that, because that is one thing that I was going to bring up. Please add a summary at the beginning or some sort of intro or something, right? Before you go on to these are the technical skills that I want to show you that I have, let me spend a couple of sentences talking about the kind of person I am, right? So let's just read this and I'll comment more on it afterwards. I'm a web developer. This is great because this may or may not match with the person or the company that I'm here. I can immediately see that this person is probably looking for a position in web development. That's really good. That's something that was missing from the others, where it wasn't specifically said that this is what you're looking for. Please always do that if you know what you want. And even if you don't, try to spend some time thinking about it, because usually what happens if you want to say, well, I'll go for anything, then you usually don't get anything. You want to be able to narrow it down to either one thing or maybe two or three things at most. So definitely think about that. I'm a web developer with expertise in React and Next.js. Perfect. Very good. Both of those things are big things in the industry. With experience building and maintaining web applications, I use React, Next.js, and Tailwind CSS to build web applications. And I am always looking for new challenges and ways to improve my skills. In addition to my front-end development skills, I'm also familiar with Python, C++, and Firebase. Very well written. There are things here that we can make better for sure, and we can look at that a little bit later. But I want to give you a big thumbs up on this one. This is very well done, and I'm really glad that you put it right up there. Okay, let's look at the experience. I have developed a deep understanding of web, such as, okay, good. My blog shows me, okay, you have a link to your blog. See that? Perfect. Love this. Love this. Really, really good that you included that link. Has allowed me to share my knowledge and insights with a wider audience, and I have gained a reputation as a reliable, very nice. As a blogger, I have published annuals, for really impressive. Did you see my face? I went like, whoa, 90 plus articles and gained 416. Love that you include this here, because this is definitely something that everyone understands, whether it's the CEO at the company or the, just an intern. Everyone understands that. 90 plus articles don't just happen like that. That means that you have consistently worked over time, probably years at this point, to produce those. That tells me something about the type of person you are. And it says, have gained a combined 416,000 views. That's also something that requires work. So I love that you put it here. I would probably even put that even further up to highlight that, because that's the kind of language that everyone understands at this point in 2023. Views and articles and blogs and YouTube videos, right? Even React is not something that everyone might understand, but that is definitely something that you can use to connect with people. You want to connect with people as fast as you can. It's really well done on this one. And let's go in here and take a look at that again. You know what I like here is you got a nice picture of yourself right here. That's something also that I was going to give as advice to all of you. Please include pictures of yourself in your CV. I always like it when people do, because it just adds that little, you know, I want to connect with a human, not a PDF written with words. There's nothing human about that. I want to connect with a human, and I connect with a human by looking at a face and eyes and maybe a smile. That's how you create a connection. So do that in your CV. And if you're thinking, oh my God, I can never take a good picture of myself, get a friend to do it, or maybe go to, you know, a photography studio and have that expert take a picture of you. Yes, it costs money, but I can tell you it's a good investment. Do you agree with that? What I just said, can you please let me know in the chat? Think about not you yourself, but you're reading resumes. Would you like to see pictures of people or no? Maybe there's something I don't know here in India. That's not something I would love to hear about that. But sometimes people don't want pictures of them because it might lead to just, see, yeah, that I'm glad you brought it up, because that is definitely something. And I can't really speak about that. I'm not really, I'm familiar with it in a different way in Norway. Unfortunately, in Norway, what happens is that if your face is a Norwegian face and your name is Magnus Carlsen, then of course you're not going to probably have any problems. But if your name is maybe a little bit like mine, or even more ethnic, you can say, and you have your picture, then of course, unconsciously, you know, a person might be less likely to look for you. And that's a very valid point. And I don't know, I just haven't faced it myself ever, that kind of discrimination. So I suppose it's easy for me to say that, you know, just do this. Again, just do whatever you feel like is comfortable for you. If you don't feel like including your picture, then don't do it. But I'm saying, as a person who reads resumes, almost always, I think in all cases, actually, maybe I'm just not very racist. I like to think so, at least. I just always like to connect with human beings. But I know that this is a place where we can definitely disagree. We can have different opinions. Let's keep going here. We have education, Bachelor of Technology, Computer Science. And this here, I like how you present this. This is very easy to understand and consume. I really like, you know, the spacing that you've used here, the simple design, elegant colors, you know, very pleasant on the eyes. Good job on that. Intermediate, intercollege. I'm assuming this is like some high school or something. Is this what comes before university there? Yeah. Okay. Very nice. And you have your percentage here and your GPA. I can't really talk to anything about that. Since you all have it, I suppose it's a requirement. So, you know, it's can't really comment on that myself. Featured projects. Okay, this I'm excited about. Google Docs with Next.js. Sounds pretty cool. And you've listed out everything that you've used here in this very nice kind of tag type of way. Love the presentation on that. Good job. It's a web app similar to the Google Docs that lets you create documents. Really great way to describe this, because you take something that we already know, everyone knows Google Docs, and you say, I basically made a clone of this. It was very similar to this. Immediately have an idea of what you're talking about there in my brain. I have used Firebase to store all the users' data and next auth to authenticate users. Good job on that. Features, autosave, dark mode, and very nice, very nice. And you have your GitHub here. Let's open that up. Let's see, you got README too with a picture. Love that. Very well written. And you got all of this as well. Very, very well done. Really good. And do you have a link here too that you can try it? You probably have that at the end, I'm assuming, somewhere. Visit the production. There we go. That's the one, right? Let's open that up. Okay, there we go. Awesome. Yeah, so for some reason, this image is not working. This is what happens all the time, right? For whatever reason, this fails. Don't worry about this. It's not that big of a deal. But what I liked, what you did here, which is really an alternative to that video idea that we have, is that you basically wrote this whole article on how to use the app, and I got a bunch of screenshots. So even if the app doesn't work, it doesn't matter, because I can see it here. Very well thought through. Good job. And then, of course, I'm assuming it's the same with the rest. So let's just skip that. Skills and tools. Again, you've done it in this nice way, consistent throughout the whole CV. Tools and technologies, certifications too, and very nice. And so these are, of course, popular courses that you've completed, and you're linking to those two. Very well. Languages, English and Hindi. Perfect. Very good job. I really like this one. I don't know if I would change that much on this one. I think it's pretty good. There's just a couple of things that I would like rewrite a little bit, slightly, and maybe make it even more visual with some images, although I think this is working pretty good already. I think those were the ones that I got in the beginning, and then we have some more. But before that, though, let's take a little break because we've been going on for a while. Let's see if there was anything that I missed in the chat. Very nice. Also, looks like an open source project. Actually, pretty great. Yes, I agree. This was a good one. Okay, so do you guys have any questions before I go further? Any specific questions that you'd like me to answer or give my thoughts on when it comes to resumes? Please post them in the chat if you do. For the video, would you suggest the person explaining the project or just a video of the project? Good question. I think both. Well, okay. So if you're just making a video of yourself explaining the project, that's better than just writing about it. But if it's a project, I don't want to see the project. So definitely with the project. And if you want to put yourself, you put in that circle, right? Using Loom or something like that. Definitely show the project, I would say. Does HR see your certificate? Human resources? Oh, that's a good question. I wouldn't know how to answer that. I don't know. How many pages should a resume be? Good question. This is one of those questions that doesn't really have an answer. It could be, I think people say the fewer pages, the better. If you have 20 pages, that's definitely too many. But I think a good rule of thumb is try to say things in as few words as possible. But it's not just about that, right? Even if your resume is 3 pages, but you present the material in a very easily digestible way, right? Where there's a lot of spacing, it's easy to read, kind of like what we just saw. Then if you have more things, you can go on for like 2 or 3 pages, but anything above 3, I think, is starting to become too much, I would say. What do you guys think? How many pages? Yeah. 1 page is okay. Should we make it 2? Yeah. Yeah. I think if you're making it in like a PDF style, you really got to think hard if you're going even above 2. Like, is there anything that you're adding here that needs to be said at this point? Does being from a tier 1 college matter or only skills matter for any good placement resume? What do you guys think about that? What Anurag just asked. Is it skills or is it the fact that you come from a better college? Skills? Yeah. Both? Yeah, see, this is something that I really can't speak that much of because, you know, it's not like that so much in Norway. There really are no tier 1 schools. I suppose you can call them that, but people don't really care that much about that here. But I know that's different in other places. But I would say that I think if you... Okay, so if someone was applying for a job, let's go outside of India, and they went to Harvard University, probably good to include that pretty high up because everyone knows what Harvard University is known as one of the best universities in the world. And so a person is going to go like, oh, wow, it's probably going to go like that, right? And do you want that reaction? If yes, then include it. But if you come from, you know, university like I went to that most people don't even know about, then, you know, I just included it at the end. It doesn't really matter. And even in both cases, whether you went to Harvard or a no-name university, it is at the end of the day, the skills and the concrete things that you've produced and you can show that I bring this to the table that matter. But you have to also understand that the world works in a certain way and there are people in the world and people that are looking at your resumes that get impressed by certain things, right? And if you know that that's going to happen, why not include it, right? If you had that opportunity, then do it. But if you don't, then don't worry about it. And don't, then you just, you know, put it maybe at the end. So Guess it depends on the job. We pay attention to that because we create a world where the anxiety. If we pay attention to it, then it does, because it will just create a weird anxiety inside you that you just increase your productivity. Yeah, yeah. Tier one college gives opportunity, skills, and enhance his resume. Who doesn't know Waterloo? Lol, the Harvard of Canada. Yeah, it's more like the MIT of Canada, I think. Oh, do you guys know Waterloo? I didn't know. It's not, I mean, it's kind of known for computer science and math. But, okay, well, that makes me feel a little bit good that you do. When it comes to education, really, my thoughts on this is this. I personally have not been asked about my education ever. I can't remember a time when I was, and I've been to several job interviews in the last 10 years now, since I didn't even include my, like, I didn't even complete my degree. I dropped out after 2 years, but that was 10 years ago now, actually. That happened in 2013. And I can't remember a time that people asked about that, because I always have so many other things to talk about than that. And I think that's the key thing. You want to try to give them a sense of the type of person you are. And the way you do that, especially you guys that are basically Gen Z and you've grown up with the internet and, you know, computers and all that, you all probably have created things, whether that be memes or written short stories or made YouTube videos or created Discord communities or played games or whatever it is, right? That tells me so much more of the type of person you are than whichever university you went to and what you did there, especially if you're not that much into it, right? If you studied history at university and now you want to apply for becoming a web developer, right? So really, it's all up to you. If you did things that were interesting and that tell them something about you, then include it. Or rather, include it more at the top, right? You probably all always want to put the education somewhere there. Okay, let's see. Let's open up the last two. Let's see that in here. Okay, and then this one. All right, okay, I think these are going to be pretty close to the others too, so we can get to the hopefully good part where we can kind of try to think a little bit outside of the box, right? Because that's the thing that I hope that you can take with you with this event, is that CVs don't need to be a certain way. There are fewer rules than you think there are. And so that, or let's spend some time on that. But before that, let's quickly go through the last two. Okay, so good job on the summary at the beginning, profile info. Well done. This one is also something that you've put some work into, making it look nice. I can see that. Did you see already from the ones that we went through, you have spent some time on the design? And a person will see that. They will see that change from most of the others. Let's see, you said front-end web developer and educational technologist. I don't know what the second thing means, but the first thing, I know exactly what it means. And so it says, okay, well, that's what you're interested in, most likely. You got your skills here, your education, and then the work experience. Let's have a look at that. Oh, you worked as a code reviewer at Squirmba. Record code reviews for Squirmba's bootcamp students, evaluating React solo projects using Squirmba's interactive coding platform. And I'm assuming if I click here, if it's possible to click. No, it's not possible to click. Here, if you're comfortable with it, I would include a link to one of your code reviews. So I can see that, right? So how your voice and how you present things, how you explain, that would be a good thing to include here. What else do we have here? School library media specialist, full-time librarian. For the Library Media Center, grades 9. Okay, redesign and currently maintain the library's website. Okay, very cool. This is actually pretty cool. So let's zoom in on this. So here, You say that school library media specialist. Would this be when you were in high school, I wonder? Or MS Library and Information Science? Let's see. Okay. Let me see if I understand this here. So school library media specialist, 2018 to present. Yeah, there you go. So Great Neck South High School. So what I'm asking here is that, were you a student here yourself, or you were the, you worked there, right? As a school library media specialist. Yes, that's probably what it's supposed to be. You work there now, right? Yes. Okay. So then I completely misunderstood. So I was thinking like you were a student there or something like that. That's on me. So full-time librarian for the Library Media Center, grades 9 to 12, redesign and currently maintain. This is pretty cool. I wish you kind of highlighted this in this in some way, because that is really cool that you did that as a project yourself. Collaborate with teachers to design lessons and incorporate educational technology applications. Co-chair of technology committee, advisor of after-school coding club using, you know what? This is so cool. You did a lot of stuff here. I don't know how you would do it because it would maybe take up a lot of space, but there's plenty of stuff here that I'm just kind of burning to ask you about. Like, oh, wow, you did that. Can you show me the website? How does it look? You taught coding to kids after school using Raspberry Pi. That's so cool. So you could probably make this into much bigger. And this is also something that this is actually pretty good, because this is giving me, depending on who the person is, for me, this is really interesting, at least. This is giving me a bunch of content to come back to when I do talk to you on the phone or invite you in for an interview, where I would go much into that. So that's actually a pretty good point, where if you write things in a way where the person later on is like, this is really interesting. Can you tell me more about that? This is really interesting. This, how did you do this? So good job on that. This is really cool. You have a website linked on your current resume. Okay, perfect. Okay, let me see here. So web developer and designer, Long Island University, Brooklyn, New York, and developed University Center website in a 6th region. Designed visually attractive interfaces and web pages based upon approved site core templates and university design standards. Implemented HTML5 coding practice and based on it. This is so cool, because this tells me that whoever this person is, that they are a person who takes initiative. Because a library's website doesn't by itself become designed and redesigned and maintained. That's a person that is actively trying to tell the people that are making decisions that, hey, I can do this, I can do this, I can take care of that problem. And that's giving me subconsciously, right? Not that directly, but it's giving me information. Okay, this is a person who takes initiative. They complete things, they've produced things, which are all really positive points. So good job. The only thing that I would comment on here is that maybe it's a little bit too technical in some cases, like Sitecore. I personally don't know what that is. I'm assuming that's kind of some sort of a WordPress type of thing, a CMS, yeah, content management system. But if you said that, you know, Sitecore's content management system, that again would make it easier for someone to understand, rather than having to, you know, on the other side, like you already have that here. I was the one who missed that. There you go. You already have that. So that's good. Projects. And here you, of course, you're going to probably add this later. Good job. Really well done. Okay. So now let's see how we can come up with some out of the box ideas on how to make a resume. All right. Let's take a little tiny 1 minute break while I set this up on my end. Let's see. And And I think I'm going to do one of these, and I'm going to try to make it very applicable to all of the resumes that we saw today. So we don't spend too much time on this. Now, before I do this, does everyone here know what Figma is? The design tool Figma. Can you say yes or no if you know or don't know what it is? And if you do, can you please give a description of Figma in one or two sentences? What is Figma to someone who doesn't know what it is? A design tool? Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah, I suppose that's a way to describe it. I would say, does anyone here use Figma on a regular basis? Can you say yes or no? Regular basis. You use it at least a couple of times a week, let's say. No, not on a regular basis. Yes, Zach says yes, sometimes. Mm. With Scrimba, of course, yes. Figma as a part of the curriculum. Also, you need to kind of go there for the solo projects. Okay, let me tell you about Figma. It's one of my favorite applications ever, really. It's one of the most impressive applications that I've ever seen. When I first understood the power of Figma, I've been using it for a couple of years now. It's something that is so flexible and so versatile that it almost can be used for almost anything, really. And the reason I say that is because at the end of the day, all of us have ideas in our brains. And those ideas are based on experiences that we've had and the people that we have in our lives and the movies that we watch and the music that we listen to and the way that we take in the world, right? And those things come in through different senses. And those things in our brain just kind of stay there and linger. And then when the right moment comes, and let's say you're talking to Pooja, for example, and she makes a really good point about something, right? And then in that moment, something clicks that you've been working on yourself for a while, and you get this idea. Can someone please verify, is that kind of how it happens for you sometimes? It's very hard to explain, but that's kind of how it works, right? You're working on something, right? And you're supposed to solve this problem, or it's assignment or something, right? And you just can't get it when you're actively working on it. But you're making tea or you're going out and you're on a walk or something like that. And then the brain is always working on stuff in the background. And we don't understand how that works. At least I don't. But it does. And just things kind of are moving around. And then this thing kind of clicks with this thing. And then there's a link that's created. And like, yes, I got it. When that happens, what I do personally is I take out my phone and I note it down in a note application. And let me tell you, I've been doing this for almost 2 years now. And it's completely transformed my life, changed it in unimaginable ways. I started doing this because I had to, because I was just going crazy with all the ideas and stuff that I was coming up with in my brain, and I didn't have a way to write it down. But I did. And now, since I started doing this in July 2021 now, I have in my notes, which I'm not going to show you because a lot of it is private, of course, but it's more than 4,000 notes that I've made since then. Imagine that, 4,000 things in my brain that would otherwise not have been written down are written down. Now, what that does is this, and I promise you this has something to do with CVs and resumes, even though it might not look like it. When you're working, the way that we live our lives, we're still human beings that are, even though AI and ChatGPT is coming out, we're still human beings who are just a result of millions of years of billions of years of evolution. We have devices, but they're separate from us. We have to interface with them using our fingers and our body parts. And the problem now is that we have so much content that we consume. Think about this. Think about how much content you have consumed in the last month. Now, have some sort of idea of how much that is. Now, go back 40 years or 30 years where your parents were your age, let's say, and think about how much content they consumed in a month. I mean, how much more do you consume? Give me a number. How many times more stuff do you consume now easily than what they did 30 years ago? Do you have some guesses about that? 10 times more, 100 times more, 15 times more, Anurag says. It's got to be somewhere around 100 or 1,000 even. Just think about it. I mean, when you're on Instagram looking at photos, if they wanted to look at photos, basically it's only on magazines. And if they had the money to have those magazines, and they go through one magazine with pictures, and you can do that like this within 5 minutes. It's completely insane. Now, do your parents have a different kind of body or brain than you? No, our brains and bodies have been the same for at least modern humans, at least 40,000 years ago. And that hasn't changed. But the amount of information that we're consuming and the rate of development of technology is exponentially increasing. Now go back another 30 years to when your grandparents were your age. And you can see where I'm going with this. Our lives is becoming more and more complex. And part of that is this. In order to be valuable and productive in this job market, your best bet is to get really good at using the computer, because that's our main tool. Whatever you're doing, doesn't matter if you're a writer or a programmer, you're using the computer. That's the constant thing between basically all occupations in the world in this at this point. And it's even that is increasing. More and more things that aren't directly tech are being eaten up by tech. Am I making sense? Would you agree with that? It must be like that in India too, right? Even more so probably. Yeah, so when that's the case, a problem that I think all of us run into is we have just so many things going on in our brains and we have no way of expressing ourselves, right? And so bringing out a notes app and writing down your thoughts is one way of doing it. But another way that I use in addition to my notes app is Figma. Because some ideas can be written down, but some other ideas need to be expressed visually. And for me, that is what Figma is for. To exchange and communicate your ideas with another human being in a visual way. And when you understand that using something like Figma, you can use other alternatives too, then a whole new world opens up. Because whereas before you were limited to the PDF format, which is predominantly text, you can add a little bit of pictures too. If you're going for Figma, it's like you are giving someone something in 3D while everyone else are just stuck in two dimensions. That's kind of how it is. So a whole different world opens up, and now you can create something more. So with that set up, hopefully that made sense to everyone. Let's see what we can do in Figma. Let's see. There we go. Okay, so since all of you basically are familiar with Figma, I'm going to go a little bit fast. But all this you can learn by yourself too if you think it's a little bit overwhelming. But I'm going to explain everything as we go. So let's start with a frame. And I'm going to go with a paper frame of A4. Let's just start there. All right. So what do I want to do here? I can start with anything. I can start with my name, but you know what? I want to go back to what I said earlier. I want to make a human connection with someone. I want to lock eyes with them right away through the computer. I'm going to do that by putting a picture of myself here. So let me open up something on the side here and get a picture of myself. There we go. Copy that and put that right in there. There we go. And I'm going to make that a little bit smaller. And then I'm going to put it right up here. And I'm going to make that a circular picture just because I think it looks nicer. I'm not going to focus too much on the design here. That's up to you. But let's add perhaps a little stroke. There we go. Okay. Looking pretty good already. I'm going to put my name here. There we go. And I'm going to make this as large as I can. Not as large. There we go. Make that bold. Now, this resume at this point has almost nothing, but let's just stop here to appreciate what has already probably happened. Whoever person is going through the resumes, they are seeing, and again, I'm not showing these because these are not good resumes. I'm just showing you how most people think about this. They are mostly seeing this stuff. You really got to think, what is the person feeling, the person who's going through this? They've probably looked at this type of resumes, at least 50 of them before they came to this one. And instantly, you put them in a place where they're like, whoa, who is this person? They have this nice smile, good picture, and their name is here. Automatically, you've put yourself in a different league, just like that. Now, what can we do with this? Remember, your resume is just a starting point. What a person can do is take this name and put it in Google and start Googling them, right? This is something that we all do now, even though if we don't like to, you know, always admit that we do it. But you're also giving them that. Here you go. Google me. Find me on Instagram, Twitter, whatever, right? Now, one thing that I'd like to add here, if you are on social media, and especially if, who was that person who did that? This one. You know, if you have your blog here, like the way that you did this, this I think I really like. So I'm going to take a screenshot of this and put this right in here for some inspiration. Let's put that right here. Okay, let's make that a little bit smaller. And let's see what I can copy from this. Okay, so web developer, I like. This is really good. I'm going to keep that because that shows the person exactly what you're good at and which position you're looking for. Okay, and then you have your information, your private information. That is pretty good to include up here. Very easy access, right? So let's just do that very kind of, you know what this is referring to. Let me just make a rectangle for that. So that denotes that. And then you got your socials. Again, I think this is really cool. Now, here, one thing that you can do, which let's go back to this one here and go to the blog that you have. Let's open this thing up here. Let me see what we can take from here. So what you can also see here, the dev, which they're kind of also almost making a resume for you, right? Be very open to copying stuff that other people have done. What they've done here is that they put your picture up here and then they put your name up here and then they make you write this bio, right? That makes sense. So let's do that. Now let's put a little bio here. And again, we're not gonna spend too much time on exactly writing something. I think you can all come up with something good. Let's make that a little bit smaller here. There we go. And maybe even smaller, 12. Yeah. And put that here. Maybe we wanna put this like this here. Now, a couple of things that, a couple of tips here about writing this text. Do you have any ideas? I want you to think about this for a second. What are things that you can put here for like the bio text? Come up with some ideas. What would you put? Choose a good font, I agree. What about the content? Emoji, that could be fun. Yeah, I agree. Emojis could be a nice touch. Any more ideas? What can you put here? You're skeptical about emojis. I kind of see what you're saying, Pooja. Can you say why? Do they add anything? I can kind of see what you're thinking. If you wanted to make something fun and lighthearted and kind of, you know, something that might prompt a laugh, then maybe, but definitely not too much. And I agree, maybe it's a little bit too much to use emojis here. You got to figure that out for yourself. If it makes sense, if you have a resume where you have an emoji themed resume, right? Because you're designed it in a way where there's emojis everywhere, then maybe it would make sense. But if it really kind of clashes with the style, then I agree. You got to maybe it's not good. Yeah, right. Mm. So does really no one have ideas about the content here? It is a difficult one. I mean, writing something here in just a couple of sentences, that's a difficult one. I agree. You know what I would do? My thoughts on this is they've seen my face. They know my name. They know what I do now, basically, web developer. Here is my opportunity to tell them a little bit about myself. But even more than that, this is a really big bonus, is make them laugh maybe a little bit, or maybe make them connect with myself a little bit. So how could you do that in a fun way? Let's see. Let me see if we can think of something here. So let's see. Let me see if I've actually written that somewhere before. I think we have something on the Scrimba about page that I wrote, which wasn't exactly for this, but it kind of applies a little bit, I think. Let's see. Yeah, okay, so I wrote this, which I don't know what you think about this. Let's put this here. So I said, code addict, sucker for true crime docs, and occasional amateur chef. I don't know if you think this is funny, but this is kind of like something fun and very short, right? So you could go this route. Now, the point I want to make about this is that you can't, that's my Scrimba bio, yeah. And you don't want to go, my opinion on this is that you don't want to take yourself too seriously. You want to make it fun. If you can make it fun, it's so much better than all the thousands of other resumes that are just going to be the same and boring. Really, I mean, that's what it all comes down to. Because people want to hang out with fun people. All people in the world would much rather talk to a person who's more fun to talk to and they have jokes and all that kind of stuff than a person who talks like this. Hey, my name is Rafid Hola and I like to do this and I do that. Nah. Don't you agree? And that's what you get. I'm going to want to convey through your CV. So if you can do something that other people can't, like juggling, right? You can put that in here. Can juggle with five balls or something like that, right? Or if you want to make a joke about how much Netflix you watch, you can say something like, when I'm not binging great shows on Netflix, I make websites or something like that. You kind of get the idea, right? You got to do some thinking here, but this is very apt for foreign countries. I don't think people are that open-minded yet. That's a good point. Would you say that you agree with Avinash on this one? Yes or no? To some degree, and I think he's right. Yeah, you know what? That might be right. So what do you think would happen if I was to apply with something like this in the beginning? Do you think it would be an immediate no from people who were looking at this? We have to apply for on-campus placements where GPA matters with skills, right? A lot of us are targeting remote roles. But if you're applying for a model, then it should work. Is it really that close-minded in India? Am I really that not familiar with it? So you have to make it a certain way. Otherwise, they don't even like...
Actually, this is not a norm to have such kind of resume. And I've gotten my resume reviewed from a couple of people here, like professionals who are working in the tech industry in India. And they usually don't approve of having memes or any kind of fun element in your resume. They just want it to be strictly professional.
Really?
That's why the idea that you proposed in the last event and you right now, it is very new to us.
Yeah. Oh my God. Wow.
Yeah.
Wait, so did you, okay, so did you, have you, so has anyone here done something very different with their resume and then shown it to the people that are, and then to get, because you can still like include everything that they want to you, for you to do in this as well, right?
Yeah, I'm yet to actually make a Figma resume like you've suggested, but I definitely make one and see what I can do with it.
Because I would, I mean, that's so hard for me to believe that it would be, that it would like see, because at the end of the day, the person has really put in work and they still have included all the things that you have to include. You always got to make sure if there are things, then you do include that. Does it really matter which pixel it is at, really, if it's here or down there? I don't really know. I don't know if I'm so I think
that makes sense.
Yeah,
It shouldn't really matter, but I haven't seen many people do this.
So that's another thing, right? That's another thing. That's, I think, a different thing. If people haven't done it yet, it just hasn't been done before. And so, but this is really interesting. I'm glad you guys are giving a little bit of resistance here, because this makes me want to investigate this further. So I think, let's not stay on this. I kind of get the point here, but this is a good insight for me then, that this is, it's so kind of ingrained in everyone that it has to be a certain way. Because if I give you a bunch of advice here and you, it's not going to really change, then, you know what, it's just a waste of time. So this, let's see what more we have here. I don't think they'll deny it. They will have a look. Then we'll see your skills. Damn, in India's IT's rule, IIT's rule, and after them, NIT's and their life is boring. GE is really harder than boring resumes. Oh, damn. Yeah. Wow. This really makes me think, because who do you think? Okay, so let's flip it now. And I, rather than me talking towards you, giving you some advice, let's flip it. Who do you think would be good to talk in the industry to learn more about this? And if it really is true that if you gave a little bit of a different kind of resume, if it would work or not, would it be just contact the companies? Or would it be recruiters? Or do you have any ideas there? I think these kinds of resumes are very helpful for design roles and some jobs that require creativity. As I work remotely to a European country company, I have seen my design colleague having a similar resume. Okay, recruiters, I think. Okay. All right. So this is a very good point. This gives me a lot to think about. So I think... Actually, I want to end this event here, because I really don't want to have you stay for stuff that you don't really think is going to work. This is so different, because, see, my personal experience with this is, of course, with, I only applied for companies in Norway, and then there was also a US company that I applied to, remote position, a US company. And basically, from all the people that I heard back from, I was, and there were two companies that I don't think even looked at my resume. But apart from that, everyone commented on how out of the box it was, as a good thing, of course. And I also got through to the, you know, kind of next thing after that. So let's see, because it will be different than what most people have, I'm definitely going to try it. Your Notion resume is amazing. Exactly. Yeah, but see, when you're saying it's different from what other people will have, you're saying that as a negative, because you're saying that you will stand out too much, and it's a negative, right?
Well, that depends. If I have a lot on my resume and I can compete with other people who have applied for the same role, and mm-hmm. my resume has a creative element, then I think I should be picked.
Yeah.
If I say, if I just on a base level don't compete with other people, then of course I stand no chance.
Yeah. Yes, of course. Of course. Yes, 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 yes. That's a very good point. This all assumes that you actually have stuff to bring to the table, of course. And this is more kind of trying to tell your story in a more creative way, in a more visual way, and hopefully a more fun way. Yes, it would definitely bring the unique element to it, but there would be a certain balance of the funkiness, right? Okay. All right. So I think, you know what? We've already gone ahead pretty above time. I would like to thank everyone. Thank you so much for coming here. I have quite a few things that I want to try out after this, because you really have made me think. And as you guys know, I was born in India, but only lived there until 5, and I'm more familiar with the European system, Norwegian system, US system. And this really makes me think that I have to do more research before talking more about this. And I think what I'm going to do is, I don't think I can do that with myself, but I think I'm going to probably try to find some creative ways to get some feedback from people to really try to test this hypothesis. Because I see what you're saying, but I don't really believe you when you're kind of saying that it might not be a positive, and they say not to include these things. I'm not so sure if I believe that. So that's what I want to try out. I think we'll end there. Actually, I'm sorry if this was a kind of a different twist at the end here. But if you have any ideas for me, please let me know I think Twitter would be best. Give me as much information as you can about specific like companies and recruiting companies, any type of URL or anything like that, that you think can be helpful. And I'm going to spend a little bit of time testing this out, doing some of my experiments. And then hopefully we can do another follow-up to this one, where I have some more concrete things to, fight you back on a little bit. Because at this point, you guys are the ones that are living through this, and you know way more about this, how things work in India. So it would be foolish of me to say that you're wrong. But I think we do need some data on this. Because at the end of the day, I still think that whether you're Chinese or Indian or Norwegian, we're all still human beings at the end of the day. And we kind of are attracted to the same kind of things, right? So it would be very surprising to me if that was different. Contacting people from Bangalore, I'll definitely do that. Your points on descriptions were very good. Thank you so much. I hope those were helpful. Yes. So thank you everyone for joining. I still hope that you got some value out of this session and that you found it helpful. I will promise you that there will be a sequel to this event, the return of the CV, the return of the creative CV. This was genuinely a great session. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Thank you to Pooja as well to organizing this. And yes, have a great rest of the evening on Sunday, and I hope to see you next time. And thank you so much for being here. I definitely learned a lot during this.
Thank
event.
You so much, Rafit. This was insanely value-packed, like the last one. And mm-hmm. I really love your dedication, how you want to investigate on whatever new thing we tell you about, how you want to talk to people. And if you want my help in any of this, then please let me know. I'll be there to help. And thank you so much for all the resume reviews. I'm definitely sure everybody got great value from it. And I hope we'll have you soon again.
Yes, definitely. I have some ideas for other events that we can do. Please let me know if you have any ideas as well. on Twitter is probably the best place to put that. But one of the things that I already kind of pitched a little bit to Pooja was getting some other people that I know, industry experts, like designers, some of my friends, some people who work at Squirmbo with me, some of the teachers, and we could do, you know, something where more people are involved, and maybe it's something like you have your projects reviewed by us or something like that. I think that would be one of the ideas. But if you have anything more, please feel free to reach out to me on Twitter and let me know. I'd love to hear it. Twitter or Discord, of course. Thank you so much for having me, and I'll see you next time.
Thank you so much.
Bye, everyone.